Thomas time. It's Thomas time. What is going on, guys? Welcome to yet another Thomas and Friends Garry's Mod reaction video. Today we are reacting to, I think, which might be one of the funniest one I've done so far. It is called Thomas and Friends The Diesel Problem. Alright?
Hello, Thomas.
Hello, Diesel. How are you?
I'm fine. By the way, I've got something for you.
Oh, he's good!
Enjoy this.
Oh no.
Just why?
How did they make Thomas that black and dirty? I don't remember that. Was I changing some textures or something?
Oh look, it's Gordon. Hey Gordon, how are you?
Hello Thomas, I'm fine, thank
you. That's not
you.
Gordon.
Gordon, why do you look so different?
Oh, different? Well, I've got a new paint job. Oh.
Oh no, it's Diesel again.
Goodbye.
So annoying, Diesel. Oh, again, guys.
Okay.
That's like dirt, Thomas.
Let's fix this.
That was a really cool map, by the way, I remember.
Alright, time to get some coal.
Look! Look, guys. A movie mistake. Have you been watching some movie mistakes on YouTube? Now that's the one. Find something which is wrong here. I give you a few seconds. You see? That's a camera right here. That's a camera mod for Garry's Mod. Basically, that's how I recorded the whole thing. I put a bunch of small cameras. This is like the first time I see it, by the way. I never noticed it before. They were like placed in front, on the back, outside, and then I connected them. And then cameras were moving, like, you know, around Thomas, 1 second, third, fourth, and that's how I made these, you know, shots. So that's a movie mistake right here.
What's wrong?
Diesel did something again. A banana?
A banana? It's Diesel again. I don't need this.
No, not
Hello,
first.
Everybody.
Oh, poor Percy is going to sleep! That's pretty much real life physics right here.
Whoops!
Oh
That's
my
what
god,
bananas
Percy,
do to you.
Are you alright?
I'm totally not alright.
Useless engines.
Right. That was probably some Looney Tunes sound effect from like old cartoon.
Time for some fun.
He switches the tracks, and the tracks will lead into
Thomas
probably like a
this.
Cliff. Oh, he changes the sign as well. No, Thomas isn't aware about that. No, Thomas, don't go there.
Oh no.
Ah.
Not again.
Is that Bart Simpson?
He's
no.
He's so annoying. I need to hide somewhere.
He's going to bump into Thomas, I think.
He will never find me here.
Thomas, Diesel was right behind you. And you thought hiding in a tunnel when a train is right behind you? Yeah, that's a great idea. No doubt about it.
Singing in the bathtub.
This can't be.
Watching all my troubles go swinging down the drain.
Man.
This is stupid.
Not as stupid as Diesel standing at top of the building. He's teleporting.
Such an annoying engine. I don't want to see him again. Oh. Wow. James Space Experiment. Explore space. A place where nobody will disturb you.
Only for really useful engines, by the way. And that James helmet. How did they come up with this?
This is exactly what I need.
So that one I remember it. I will explain to you guys, just a second.
Alright. Are you ready?
Yes. Finally. I will never see this annoying diesel again.
So basically, Thomas decided that the only place he can possibly hide from Diesel would be space. And the problem here was that... Alright, let's just watch a little bit and I will stop.
Go.
All engines ready. Deploy.
So basically what happened here is that I did build this Thomas rocket, alright? I put an engine right at the back of the Thomas and I genuinely thought that I would make it fly. But for some reason, it wouldn't fly. It wouldn't fly. Thomas would just crash or would just fly like that. He would just fly in a spiral and crash into James or something. He wasn't flying straight until I realized, why don't I just put an engine at the back of the Thomas? And then I would just press the button to make the engine go broom. What I did was I moved Thomas with the physics gun. So I'm flying somewhere around here carrying Thomas with the physics gun, but it never worked out. Here he comes! Thomas goes to space! That's so good. Silence, guys. Nobody will find us here. NASA. That's probably International Space Station, by the way. The map. Houston, we've got a problem. There's Thomas flying.
Finally.
What? Yeah. Oh.
All right. This is it.
Okay, Thomas built a rocket, but how Diesel got in this space? How?
What?
Hello, Diesel.
Everybody is Gordon!
How are you, Diesel? What's up?
I'm getting out of here.
So, Thomas finally united with his friends Percy and James and decided to teach Diesel a lesson. The only question I've got, is there like a store, Gordon's store, where they are selling Gordon's face masks? I mean, where did they get them from?
Thank you guys. I think he finally learned his lesson.
James' face looks pretty scary here. I'm wondering if it's the same James model from the old videos or maybe not. Or it's the shadows, but he looks pretty intimidating.
We will tell him it was a joke, but definitely not today.
Excuse me, has anyone seen my faces?
Basically, Gordon is probably in possession of his face masks, which doesn't make sense at all. But of course, guys, just like Thomas and Friends Ghost Train video, there's no way we're going to stop here. A lot of you guys voted for Thomas and Friends Back to the Future video. That video doesn't have any voice acting or any coherent story. Guys, if you haven't seen Back to the Future by this point, watch it. Your parents watched it, everybody watched it, it was released in 1985 and the following sequels, it's like one of the best trilogy ever.
Back to the Future.
And Marty McFly randomly shouting Back to the Future. That is the DeLorean from the third movie. As you can see, there are time components on the front. What's that? Thomas? Thomas in 1885. He's gonna bump into DeLorean.
It's a science experiment!
There is a funny story about that. This is Doc Brown, obviously from Back to the Future, but his model did not have eyes, particularly, which is why you will never see his face like in front.
Ready to roll!
So just like in Back to the Future 3, Doc Brown is inside the train and Marty is already inside the DeLorean. The flux capacitor is fluxing. The biggest problem here was I was doing it alone, guys. One thing I remember was that the DeLorean's wheels, they weren't really made to match the tracks that particular railroad in Garry's mode. And Thomas was driving on his own with the invisible engine on its back. So I was just pressing the engine button and Thomas was carrying me. So it was like pretty much like in the movie, you know. But the thing is, DeLorean would keep derailing from the rail track, so I had to use some attachment tools. Basically, I glued DeLorean with Thomas. That railway wasn't here, I built it myself. So it looks like DeLorean is on the tracks, but it's not. Look, it's a little bit above the tracks. Now, just like in the movie, Doc Ock uses some boosts. Doc Brown uses some boosts. And we're approaching the dead end. The dead end. There goes the final boost. Those effects were added in After Effects, and check out the DeLorean's interior, it's so cool. We've got the time components there, we've got the alarm clock, there's the flux capacitor, it's really, really good. But the time components, you see them in the front, that was me basically building them. There weren't in the DeLorean, I wanted to, DeLorean was like from the Back to the Future 2 or 1, so I had to put the time component so it would look legit like the car from the third movie. Boom! That shot, let me explain to you, let's go back a little bit. So I had to make DeLorean travel to the future and I had to make it disappear, obviously. So what happened here is that Thomas is carrying DeLorean and then using the After Effects I made DeLorean go poof. And this Thomas is the second Thomas. He's like going right behind the second Thomas. This is the second shot. The first Thomas already crashed. This is the second Thomas which went without the DeLorean. And I cut it, edited it this way, very smooth and fluid. And he goes boom, just like the train in the third movie, destroyed. That fire effect was done in After Effects. And now we are back to 1985. Why is there Patrick there? Nothing special, I mean, just a normal day. DeLorean on the tracks. Oh no, there is a train! Marty, get out of here! Marty, get out of the DeLorean! And it gets destroyed, just like in the movie. In the movie, that was probably one of the saddest scenes when DeLorean got destroyed. When I was little, I was really sad about it. It's gone.
Well, Doc, it's destroyed.
Just like you wanted.
Just like you wanted.
Wait. But there's no train. What? It's Belle! It's Belle!
Doc! Marty!
So just like in the third movie, Doc Brown builds a time-traveling time machine train. In my case, it was Belle. And that shot is like straight from the movie. We're going back somewhere. Thanks for watching. Yeah, thanks for watching. So that was Back to the Future as well, guys. But that's not it. At least for today, that's it. But that's not it for future. We've got something else. We've got Thomas and Friends, the Ponyville. Thank you, guys. Thank you for staying with me. Thank you for watching those. Don't forget to like if you enjoy it. Have a great day, guys. And see ya in a couple of days. Bye-bye.